I went on an Antarctica cruise with the cruise line PONANT. What do I think of the whole experience? If you are thinking of doing an Antarctica cruise, are they the right line for you? Stay tuned to find out. Coming up next. Hi fellow travelers, it's Ken here and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. We went on an Antarctica cruise with PONANT on their cruise ship Le Boréal. Currently, we have finished the Antarctica cruising and we are crossing the Drake Passage to return to Ushuaia. This is a good time to review the cruise. Overall, of course, I enjoy the cruise and I really love the experience of setting foot on Antarctica and seeing all the native creatures. But let's get into a more detailed review. So first, let's talk about the equipment. PONANT is one of the few well-known expedition cruise companies with cruises to Antarctica. Their ships are more like luxury yachts. Their hardware is very good and we all enjoy sailing on Le Boreal. The facilities on board are good in general. They have a small swimming pool and although on the cruise, they only fill it up once and that was with polar water. The main lounge is a great place for gathering, trivias, and sometimes evening performances. There is a great observatory lounge to see the view at the front of the ship. And there is a big theatre which can accommodate all the guests. The gym is disappointingly small though, with very few equipment. I was hoping to keep fit a bit more during the cruise, but alas, I find it difficult given the equipment available. The stateroom itself is very nicely appointed. The bed and the mattress are both very comfortable. All drinks in the minibar are included, as are room service, which is available 24 hours a day. Next, let's talk about food. As expected of a French cruise line, the food is mostly gourmet and rarely disappoints. Most meals are served at both the Deck 2 restaurant, La Licorne, as well as the Deck 6 restaurant, La Buzo. In general, the Deck 6 restaurant, situated right by the outdoor area, serve buffet food. They are only open when the sea is calm. During Drake Passage, they often shut that restaurant because it's too unstable there. The Deck 2 restaurant is more about serving a la carte food. The food quality is generally very good. The bread is especially good as from any boulangerie in France. For lunch, they have a theme every day so that there is more variation of food being served. One day, it could be an Argentine food, and the next day, it could be Italian theme. The desserts are always excellent, and I'm sure I gain a lot of weight testing out their desserts. Dinner tends to be more fine dining. And during two nights of the cruise, they organized a gala evening where people were encouraged to dress up. Our second one was actually the Christmas gala on Christmas Eve. Overall, the quality of the food is excellent. Next, let's talk about drinks. Drinks are mostly included. However, you can pay more for more premium alcohol. During the meals, you can elect to pay extra to get better wines. And at the bars, you can pay extra to get top shelf liquor. I found there is no need to do that, particularly I was mostly having cocktails. They have a premium pass, which costs 20 euros per person per day to get unlimited access to top shelf liquor. But I think very few of us find that necessary. By the way, if the camera is shaking, it's not because I wasn't holding it still or anything like that. It's because I'm actually recording this on the sea day when we are crossing the Drake Passage back to South America. And today, we're actually getting the Drake shake. The sea is really rough and many areas have been closed. So I actually have to record this inside the room. Next, let's talk about entertainment. For a rather small ship with just 200 guests, I'm quite surprised how they have lots of nightly entertainment. They have a team of 4 female dancers, 1 male dancer, a chanteuse, a performance duo from Paraguay. Between them, they manage to run many evening shows and live music sessions. On our cruise, they arranged an impromptu concert when they found Elin Blom, a Swedish Idol contestant, was on board. They also had a couple of dancing nights, so overall we were well entertained. However, this leads to the next point. Did all this entertainment come at the expense of Enrichment Talks? So now let's talk about Enrichment Talks. When I watch other videos of Antarctica cruises, it was always stressed that instead of entertainment, you get lots of enrichment talks where onboard naturalists talk about the flora and fauna of Antarctica. There will be lectures on the history of Antarctic expedition by explorers like Shackleton, Charcot, Scott, Amundsen. History of the whaling operation, photography lessons. But unfortunately, there were hardly any talks of that nature. One day, when bad weather cancelled the Zodiac cruising in the afternoon, we were treated to a very interesting talk by a naturalist about sex in the animal's kingdom. Sadly, that kind of in-depth talk only happened once during the expeditions. We really could have done with lectures before going out to see wildlife or spot whales, and history lessons before visiting Deception Island, for example. I have no idea why they haven't done so. Talking to other cruisers on board, they expressed the same disappointment. And another cruiser who was on Le Commandant Charcot said there were plenty of lectures, so no idea why they've changed it. It's not as if there is no time to do it, as every day after lunch there is a lull with no activities for an hour or two. After the end of the expedition, when we were returning to Ushuaia, there were a lot more lectures, but really, they would have been much more useful before we got to Antarctica. I discussed this with the cruise director, and he didn't really have the answers, but he did admit that we lost a lot of lecture time on the first day when he had to accommodate the World Cup final to be shown. Given that half of the guests and almost the entire expedition team were French, it's understandable why they had to show the World Cup final. So perhaps on another cruise, it would have been different. Next, let's talk about the expedition. The expedition themselves have been very well run. They make sure everyone got on and got off the Zodiac boats safely. They make sure we follow the rules to prevent foreign materials to be introduced to the Antarctica. And sometimes the weather was really poor and they had to cancel, but that's not really their fault. They try their best to make sure everything works, but Antarctica is a hostile environment and you've just got to respect the nature. One thing I would like though is to have more time at our landings. Sometimes we're given just an hour, which felt hardly enough. At this point, I would like to invite you to hit the like button if you find this video informative. By doing so, YouTube will spread this video to a wider audience. And if you want to follow other cruise videos that I'll be releasing in the future, then please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell icon. That way, you will be notified whenever I release a new video. Next, we'll talk about parkas and boots. They provide each of us a bright red parka jacket, which we also get to keep after the cruise. That was very much appreciated. They also loan us boots, which is great. As all the landings are wet landings, you need waterproof trousers as well as a good pair of boots. I know some other cruise line require you to bring your own boots, and that would have added a lot of weight to our luggage. So the free boots rental is really appreciated. Next, let's talk about internet. Unlike many other cruise lines, internet is provided for free. It's already included in your cruise fare. It's all satellite internet, so it does work even in Antarctica. Sometimes when the ship is between mountains, the signal may be blocked, but usually after a while, once the ship moves, the internet returns. The internet speed is not fast, but it's sufficient for emails and social media, including even YouTube. I was able to manage my channel a little bit during the cruise, so that's a bonus. However, don't expect to stream your favorite Netflix movies here. I know other cruise lines charge an arm and a leg for internet, so the free internet here is a genuine advantage. Next, I'll talk about language. PONANT is a French cruise line, and a good percentage of the guests are francophones. However, if you don't speak French, it's not an issue at all. Everything is announced in both English and French, and all the staff speak both languages with varying degrees of accent. I do find that there seems to be a very little mixing between the French guests and the others. So if you're of the type who like to make a lot of friends on a cruise, then you will need to speak French in order to break into the French crowd. Next, I want to talk about an important aspect of the ship, which is the stabilizer. Le Boréal is equipped with a great stabilizer, and that's very important for Drake Passage sailing. I hardly felt any movement during the cruise. Even during the Drake Passage, when we experienced the Drake shake during the return navigation from Antarctica to Ushuaia, it was still a very manageable sailing. It might have also helped that I've chosen a stateroom that is midship and the lowest deck. But even when walking around the ship, it was mostly fine. Right, let's do a summary. If you are looking to do an Antarctica cruise in luxury, being well pampered with all the creature comforts, then PONANT is a great choice. However, while I enjoy all the pampering, I was also looking for an Antarctic cruise with lots of enrichment so that I could make more sense with what I saw during the landings. As it stood, very often, the landing was like you have just arrived at Island B, you can go to the left to see the penguins, or the right for beautiful landscape, and please come back within an hour. There is just something missing there. If I were to go on another expedition cruise again, I probably would choose another cruise line with more emphasis on enrichment talks. And so we've come to the end of this video. Why don't you click on one of these links to watch more cruise content from me? See you over there.